Well, being an 80s and 90s child, I was a massive, massive fan of Stock Aitken and Waterman when I was a kid. I love Pete Waterman songs. I just absolutely love them. And as an adult, one of the perks of becoming a songwriter and a record producer was that I had the chance to work with a lot of the people that I'd idolized growing up. And I think I steered it towards that anyway. And one of those was a lady that sung one of Stock Aitken Waterman's best ever songs, the diva, who is Lonnie Gordon. I absolutely loved Lonnie when I was a kid. And then I became friends with her manager, Dino, years and years ago. And her agent was the same agent as me, Dance Crazy Management, Kelly Wilde. And Lonnie used to sort of live between America and here, really. She was American and she used to fly over. And she was actually starring in Cirque du Soleil when I ended up working with her. And it came about because James and me were the top pop DJs on the scene, and the top house DJs, house music DJs, were the Sharp Boys, who were great friends of ours, Stephen and George. Very, very talented DJs, amazing DJs and remixers. And they'd worked with everybody from Kylie to George Michael. I mean, you name it, they'd had 9 number ones actually with their mixes. And they were just very incredibly talented people and really, really great friends. And they also worked in Vauxhall every night virtually, or certainly every weekend. And Steve was a promoter and George was the main DJ as well. And I had a great, great, great friendship with them. And plus we did some tracks together. They remixed some tracks for me, like Disco Fever remix that they did for me. And we all both had James Engineering as well. So James would engineer all our Club Kids music and co-produce, and then he'd do the same on house music with the Sharp Boys. And we ended up really moving Club Kids Productions to their studio, which was in their house in Streatham. Anyway, they'd had several meetings with Lonnie and her manager, and it was irresistible, really. They wanted to remix Happening All Over Again, which was her biggest international hit, and I loved it as well. And they asked if James and me would actually have Lonnie in the studio. And they didn't really work with singers so much, the Sharp Boys. They were remix boys, really. Whereas I was more on the production side, and James was more on the production side. And myself, especially working with vocalists, because I'm a vocalist myself. Anyway, so this deal was to-ing and fro-ing between the Sharp Boys and Lonnie Gordon, her management, and me and James, and the deal was to-ing and fro-ing. And in the end, they didn't come up with the deal until the night before Lonnie had to fly back to America. So we had to be quick. We had to re-record her vocals, and we had her in at some ridiculous time, like 8 in the morning or something, before her flight in the afternoon. And I don't know how she sung at 8 in the morning, but she was incredible. And funnily enough, I'd used a little trick which I'd used when we re-recorded Viola Wills and her hits. When we re-recorded Lonnie's, I did the same trick as I did with Viola, and I said, look, you know, it was 30 years ago that you sung the original of this song. And people's voices mature, especially if they're a diva like Viola or Lonnie, and their voices mature, but sometimes they come down a couple of notches. Maybe they're not in such a high range and such a girly range. And so I said to Lonnie, how would you feel if we changed the key to the song and brought it down a couple of semitones? And she wasn't sure. Oh, well, when we did, we tried it, and boy, did she come into her own on that vocal. Personally, I think it's better than the vocal on the original. Here's our version, recorded at 8 in the morning by the American superstar, Lonnie Gordon, and Happening All Over Again.